Feminist Creativist presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. How are you today, my dear friends? I hope, I trust, I find you well, and the Lord continues to be good to you. We are on a sequel, and the devotional for this morning is Be the Problem Fixer. And we are continuing from the one we did last Monday, How to Make a Difference. Come with me to the book of 1 Samuel. We are at chapter 17, and we begin reading at verse 5 and work our way to verse number 27. The Bible reads as follows. Previously, an Israelite man had declared, "Do you see this man who keeps coming out? He comes to defy Israel. The king will make the man who will kill him very rich and will give him his daughter. The king will also make the household for that man's father exempt from paying taxes in Israel." Skip to verse 27. The people told him about the offer, concluding that it was what will be done for the man who kills him. May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as we pray. Let us pray. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of calling upon your name. Dear Lord, there are problems that recur, problems that we cannot work our way around until we fix them. And how we pray, dear Lord, that you can make us the problem fixers in our spaces, whether it be at work, be it at home, or even in the churches. May you equip us, especially from thy word, to draw principles on how to set ourselves apart. This has been our prayer of faith. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask. Amen. My good friends, I wish to raise 5 points, but for today I will split them into subcategories of 2 main points. But in these 5 points, I want us to get this distinction. There is what is referred to as the problem fixer, and there is a handyman. If you are into movies, you must have watched movies like Your Man in Black. You may have watched movies like Your James Bond and many others. All that those movies fix, they want to speak to are issues of how to fix problems. How do you fix problems? And as you fix these problems, take note, those who fix problems of a certain level, they are the problem fixers, especially those problems that can affect a nation, problems that can affect a neighborhood, problems that can affect even a company. Those are your problem fixers. But those of us who deal with problems that do not affect things that matter, we are the handyman. So we want to appreciate how to become a problem fixer. How do you know when I solve this problem, I shall become the problem fixer and not a handyman? This brings us to point number one. Notice this as we take off. How you identify a real problem is, it must be a problem that keeps coming up. Goliath has been a problem that keeps coming up for the past 40 days. He has come up to threaten the children of Israel. He has come up to even embarrass the king of Israel. For 40 days, the problem keeps coming up. When you fix such problems, you qualify to be the problem fixer. Point number 1B. Notice that as he continues to come up, these are the things that he does consistently over the 40 days. Number 1, he defies the armies of the living God. Number 2, he embarrasses Saul and says, "Are you not servants of Saul? And let someone who come up and fight with me." He not only even embarrasses Saul, but even mocks the strategy of the children of Israel. And he says, "Why would you even go into battle formation against one man?" Whosoever fixes problems that defy, embarrass, and mock the leadership, such an one is ready to become the problem fixer. When you can fix such problems, you are a person of record. And when you have established that you are fixing problems that recur, you're fixing problems that embarrass the leadership, when you have established this, you want to look at the other element. What is in it for you? There are three issues that I want to raise. David goes on to look at these three as they are offered to him before he takes on the job. Notice at number one, he is told, whosoever will kill this Philistine, the king will make him rich. When you are a problem fixer, you do not work for people who are not rich. Secondly, you do not work for people who cannot make you rich. Why? Because the skill and expertise you have is so rare. It is hard to come across. The whole of Israel could not find a man to solve this problem for 40 days. So when you walk in, you are someone who brings a unique skill set. You do not use a unique skill set for someone who cannot pay. Good jobs are not done for free. They are not done for free. It is only God who can do jobs for free, because he already owns the cattle upon 1,000 hills. For the rest of us, when you are offering a unique skill and you find that you are doing so for a person who cannot pay for it, it is high time you walk away. Vote with your feet. Vote with your feet and go and use your skill where it shall be appreciated. Point number 2b, enable you to attain family stability. This is the other offer that is there. You know, Saul must have thought long and hard about this. He says, whosoever does this, I'm going to give him my daughter as a wife in marriage. Yes, we can go into the gender and the social characterization of women then. Maybe that's a discussion for another day. But in the job market, make sure that any job that you take must assure you of family stability. It must give you a wife if you're not married. It must retain a husband if you are married already. It must give you a husband if you are not yet ready married. It must retain a wife if you are a man and you're already married. These comforts are a basic requirement for job fixers. When you do jobs that cannot help you to take care of your wife, you are a handyman. When you do jobs that cannot help you to retain your marriage, you are a handyman. The problem fixer does jobs that will set them apart and ensure that they are set for life. And if not, walk away. Should you stick around, you have voted and prepared yourself and reconciled yourself to being a handyman. And the last bit, this man, whosoever will do this, they went on to say, his father's household shall be exempt from paying taxes. Whosoever is a problem fixer does not fix problems that benefit him or herself alone. They fix problems that once they are done, such problems make those who are downstream benefit. Let your relatives realize a return from your risking your life. Let your relatives realize a return from your putting your head on the block. Because chances, you might go on the job and never come back. And should you want to go out and fix problems, make sure you are not doing a thankless job. When you do a thankless job for people who will not appreciate, you are going to find yourself a handy person. And if you do a thankless job, you may want to make sure before you enter into this job, you do your research pretty well. Pretty well. What am I saying unto you, my dear friends? As we go into the workspaces, be the problem fixer. Arrive on time to make a difference. When you are there, you want to be sure you are solving problems that nobody else can solve. And secondly, you are going to save the face of your paymaster because you are bringing a rare set of skills. And this rare set of skill is not to be used for free. If anyone wants to take it for free, they are taking you for a ride. Walk away. But before you walk away, if the job is going to offer you something like this, monetary gain and returns, go for it. If it is going to give you family stability, go for it. If it is going to assure that your lineage and those who are connected to you live safe, sound and healthy lives, go for it. You are a problem fixer, and that is the space for you to operate. May the good Lord help you to become the problem fixer until we meet again next Monday. And I promise you, while you are a problem fixer in your own right, your very own may not believe in you. Let us meet again next Monday as we consider this particular topic. Until then, blessings and peace.